Welcome to my YouTube channel Mechanical Magic Mechanical Learning Tutorials. So in this video I am talking about some of the calculating part of an auto cycle. So let us see, the data is given. An engine working on an ideal auto cycle has a clearance volume of 0.03 meter cube and swept volume of 0.12 meter cube. The temperature and the pressure at the beginning of the compression are 100 centigrade and 1 bar respectively. If the pressure at the end of a heat addition is 25 bar, then calculate ideal efficiency of cycle, temperature at key points on the cycle, and take gamma is equal to 1.4. So first of all, from the given data, starting with the engine working on an ideal auto cycle has a clearance volume. So VC, that means, as from the PV diagram, just you can see over here, X axis it will be representing as a volume, Y axis is representing as a pressure. So here it will be the auto cycle is given to you. So constant volume heat addition and constant volume heat rejection cycle. So 1 to 2 process that will be representing as adiabatic compression process, 2 to 3 process that will be representing as a constant volume heat addition process, 3 to 4 that will be representing as a adiabatic expansion process, and 4 to 1 constant volume heat rejection process. So here from the data, V1 equal to V4, and that will be V1 minus V2, that will be called as a swept volume, or you can say stroke volume. And V2, that means the clearance volume as from the PV diagram of an auto cycle. And rest of the data, that will be P1, P2, P3 and P4. So here the data is given like clearance volume. So VC, that will be equal to V2 or equal to V3, is given to us. So VC, V2, that means it will be 0.03 meter cube. And swept volume, so up to the this data, so point VS equal to 0.12 meter cube. At initially temperature and pressure of the beginning of the compression are 100 and 1 bar, so P1 equal to 1 bar, so that should be converting into Pascal, 1 into 10 raised to 5 Pascal. T1 100 degree centigrade, so converting into Kelvin, 373 Kelvin. And the if the pressure at the end of heat addition is 25. So just you can see over here, heat addition at 2 to 3 process, and the pressure at the end of the heat addition, that means the P3 is given to us, and that will be 25 bar. So P3, 25 bar, so that should be converting into Pascal, 25 into 10 raised to 5. And one more data is given. Gamma is equal to 1.4. So let us start with the first one, the ideal efficiency of the cycle. So from the PV diagram, V1 that will be equal to VC plus VS. So V1 equal to 0.15 meter cube. Now the compression ratio that will be representing as a V1 upon V2. So just put the value of V1 over here and V2 from here. So you will get the compression ratio R, and that will be equal to 5. Now just put the value of the efficiency of an auto cycle, that means 1 minus 1 upon R raised to gamma minus 1. So just put the value of R, and that will be 5, and gamma, that will be 1.4. So just put the value and you will get the answer. Efficiency of an auto cycle, that means 0.4747, or you can say 47.47%. Second one, the temperature at key points of the cycle. So temperature at the key point of the cycle, generally starting with the process 1 to 2, that means T2 upon T1 equal to V1 upon V2 raised to gamma minus 1. So we have the value of T1 from here, V1 upon V2, that means it will be the R, and gamma it will be 1.4. So just put the value of T1, R and gamma, and you will get the answer T2 equal to 710.1 Kelvin. Now from the relations P1 V1 raised to gamma, P2 V2 raised to gamma. So P2 equal to P1 into R raised to gamma. So just put the value of P1 over here, R from here, and gamma from here, and you will get the answer of P2, that means 9.51 bar. Now here from the constant volume heat addition cycle, T3 upon T2, that will be equal to P3 upon P2. So finally we'll get the answer T3 equal to 710.1 into 25 upon 9.51. So that will be P3 upon P2. So you will get the answer of temperature T3. You can say at point number 3, temperature is 1865.1 Kelvin. Now from the expansion ratio, R is equal to V4 upon V3. So generally V4 equal to V1 and V3 equal to V2. So similar V1 upon V2. So that means it will be 5. Now the process 3 to 4, T4 upon T3, that means V3 upon V4 raised to gamma minus 1. So just put the value of expansion ratio over here and you will get the answer of T4. That means 979.7 Kelvin. So this is the simplest way to calculating the ideal efficiency of a cycle and temperature at the key point of the cycle. So here it will be the efficiency of the cycle and the temperatures, like T1 is given to you, T2, T3 and T4. So if you like it, if you understand it, then subscribe and share Mechanical Magic, Mechanical Learning Tutorials. Thank you.